Good evening, everybody. I take this opportunity to welcome the stellar panel that we have. And thank you, Fiki, for organizing Turf India in these tough pandemic and COVID times, where sports has taken a backseat for a lot of people and a lot of people. And sometimes it has gone out of the horizon, and no viewership or less viewership means less of attention. But with these kind of initiatives that Fiki has taken, it brings back the whole conversation around sports back to the main fora. Today's session is session six, the title being Impact of Government Initiatives, Halo India and Fit India, very, very good initiatives by the government. The brief that we have been given today is to revive, resurrect, and nurture Indian sports from the grassroots level. The government has introduced the Halo India program. The spirit of participation in sports and enabling the next generation to demonstrate the true potential. Similarly, Fit India movement also looks at increasing the awareness and the need for healthy life among citizens, urging for regular indulgence in physical exercises. Again, very, very important aspects that we can think of. We have a stellar panel also with us today. We have the Honorable Minister Shri Tushar Kanti Behera, sir. Mr. Tushar Kanti Behera, sir, is a teacher as well as a very learned person. Sir has been a professor at the Centurion University of Technology and Management. And he has been also an IITian with dual degree in biotech and biochemical. So, very learned man that we have. He is the minister independent in charge of Ministry of Sports and Youth Services in the government of Odisha. Thank you, sir, for coming
Thank you.
for this panel, sir. We also have Vishnu Sudhakaran, sir. He is the director at Fit India Mission Office. I think he is having a bit of a problem with his video and net, so we'll wait for him to completely join in. We also have Shri S.N. Meena, sir. Again, somebody, IIT alumnus from Delhi. More importantly, he's a marathoner who has participated and represented India in the 5,000 and the 10,000 meter Asia Masters Marathon, Asia Masters. And he's also participated in the Boston Marathon. So I don't know how you manage Halo India as well as manage to run, sir. So we'll want to hear more from you on that as well. We have Omkar Kedia, sir, as well with us. He's a FICCI Sports Committee as well as DG Sports Authority Assam. More importantly, he has been associated with the Government Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports right from 2010 onwards. I don't know where since I can remember, and since I have been in the profession, he was the Joint Secretary of the Ministry of Sports, and he's been instrumental in doing a lot of policies for India right from the the National Sports Code that we talk about. He's been instrumental in drafting and implementing it along with other policies, be it on anti-doping, be it on sport governance. So, sir has been, I would say, a veteran in this field of sports governance in India and sports movement in India. So, thank you, sir, for joining in. Last but not the least, we have
Thank you.
Nilesh. Nilesh Kulkarni. Nilesh Kulkarni is again a fellow FICCI Sports Committee member with us. He's also the founder director of IISM, which is a leading sports management institute in India. Recently, they also got recognized by the Khelo Protsahan Awards by the President of India. And more importantly, Nilesh is also a sports person, being the former cricketer. So the only not to that extent sports person is me, who's your moderator. And with this, let me invite Tushar Kanti Behera, sir, to give his keynote address, sir. Sir, we'll welcome you to give your keynote address.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good evening, one and all. Esteemed guests in the panel, Sri Onkar Kedia ji, Sri Nilesh Kulkarni ji, Sri Rohit Bharadwaj, Secretary, Sports Authority of India, Director Khelo India, Sri S.K. Meena ji, respected moderator Viduspat Singhania ji. At the outset, I would like to congratulate FICCI Sports for keeping up its tradition and conducting the annual Turf Summit even during this pandemic time. It is a platform that brings together sports persons, policymakers, state level officials, thought leaders, and professionals sector and deliberate on the different aspects of sports and paves way for new ideas. This session is about the impact of government initiatives in Khelo India and Fit India movement. Having being the part of India's sports journey and growth, we all know that government of India is looking at identifying and nurturing talent from an early age, increasing participation and producing more and more winners at the international podium, especially at the Olympics 2028 and 2032. It is also making remarkable efforts to involve and educate people on the importance of fitness for making India an active and fit nation. Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji launched the inaugural Khelo India School Games in 2018, which was a historic effort to encourage the Indian youth towards athletics and sports. It emerged as an attempt to promote competitive sports among youngsters. 2 years down the line, the national initiative is yielding great results in such a way. The Khelo India University Games is yet another commendable initiative to integrate sports into the higher education sector. Earlier this year, Odisha hosted the inaugural edition of the game, which saw over 3,500 athletes participation from over 150 universities from Pan India. While many medals were won and records were made, it also turned out to be a celebration of sports and culture extravaganza. Both the platforms have been successful in unearthing great sporting talents from a young age. To shine at this has become aspiration for athletes. Khelo India events are collectively boosting the sports culture in the country from the grassroots level as well as national and international podium. It is paving the way for centers of excellence in sports and improving the sports infrastructure in India as well as identifying and nurture promising sports talents. It is also boosting the business of sports and in many ways positively impacting the economy too. Similarly, the people-centric Fit India movement launched by Honorable Prime Minister in 2019 has been successful in mobilizing people from all walks of life, especially during the pandemic times that had greatly restricted our movements. It has done so through a series of activities, dialogues, and dedicated online programs. So, sportspersons, federations, state associations, government officials, and even celebrities have turned brand ambassadors for this movement. The movement has seen a collective participation of more than 3.5 crore Indians in various events, with more than 2.5 crore participants in the Fit India Run with a digital footprint of 30 crore people. Recently, government and state launched the Fit India guidelines for all age groups in regional language for larger outreach, so more and more people can benefit from that movement. These proactive initiatives have been widely appreciated and lauded globally by the sports fraternity, and it gives me immense pride to be a part of this growing and evolving sports sector in our country. And now I would like to hear others share their views and ideas on this subject. I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to be here for the keynote speech. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us, sir. Sir, I think let me start with the first question as an opening bowler to you, you only, sir, before we can move to everybody else. I know Nilesh is a spinner, so he should come in later. sir, you've talked about the university games and the first time Odisha hosted these games in March, April, February, March. This year, sir. With about over 3,500 athletes, 159 universities, 17 sports, 11 venues. You know, it's a huge game, sir. So, sir, I think what I would want to ask you is, sir, what has been the impact of these games on the youth in Odisha, sir? But how have they taken these games and how have they been motivated by these games, sir?
First of all, I would like to thank our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Navin Patnaik ji, for his visionary work, Sports for Youth and Youth for Future. So from 2015 onwards, we have built in every block one mini stadium so that the rural sports, mostly in Odisha, hockey, football, volleyball, and kabaddi. This kind of sports can be appreciated by people at all walks of life. And rural people, mostly at block level, then they come to district level, then they come for state level and national level. So the aspirational value has been increased, and to see themselves at the pedestal of national and international level, the competition is high, and that also creates a brand value. So I think it has created a higher impact on the rural people and rural students, specifically among youth.
Thank you, sir. Vishnu, are you online or are you still struggling with your audio and computer? Just checking before we can move on. I think Vishnu is still struggling. Meena sir, I think I can come to you then, sir. Sir, considering this situation, the unfortunate situation rather of the pandemic and learning moving for in even schools and colleges online, now how does the government or this Khelo India program now look at spreading participation and spreading awareness at the grassroots level? What is the plan during the pandemic and maybe subsequent to it? Is there any plan that Khelo India has?
Yes, yes. Namaskar, Honorable Minister, sir, and respective juries, panelists. Yes, Khelo India, during pandemic situation, we never stopped. At the need of the hour, immediately, Sports Authority of India and Khelo India took an initiative, and it was widely appreciated through athlete coach education program. Through at least we conducted this program for grassroots athletes and involving coaches, various academies, various institutes in 21 sports disciplines. And participated through all structured program was conducted for beneficial of athlete coaches, aur unko pura ek program banaya unke sath online coaching ka, and pura program kiya, so that is samay pe bhi hum log bahut acche se एथलीट को और कोचेस को ये कर पाए. एंड नाउ फॉर कमिंग डेवलपिंग नीड ऑफ द अवर से वी आर डेवलपिंग खेलो इंडिया की पाठशाला, विच इज ए वन स्टैंडर्ड प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर ऑल ग्रास रूट एथलीट, पी टीचर, कम्युनिटी कोचेस, विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑल स्टेक होल्डर्स लाइक पॉलिटिशियंस एंड वेरियस इमिनेंट सबके साथ मिलकर हम एक प्लेटफॉर्म बना रहे हैं जहाँ स्ट्रक्चर्ड प्रोग्राम बच्चों के लिए और इमिनेंट कोचेस के लिए डेवलप होगा. और वो वी आर नॉट लिमिटिंग अवरसेल्फ टू फ्यू स्पोर्ट्स, एवरी स्पोर्ट्स वी आर ट्राइंग टू कवर, एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू एंड स्टेट ऑफ द आर्ट टेक्नोलॉजी को वी आर ट्राइंग टू कन्वर्ट इनटू ए प्लेटफॉर्म.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. आई थिंक वी हैव विष्णु बैक. विष्णु, आर यू देयर?
Yes, yes. Unfortunately, a lot of network issues. Then,
no problem.
Sorry.
So let me put the difficult question to you, since you've been missing the initial session. You know,
yes.
The whole Khelo India and particularly Fit India, Khelo India being a subset of Fit India, talks about the importance of sports and physical training in our lives. You know, so I just wanted to understand from you, what is the government's vision and the mission out of these, and how do they see it progressing year on year? How did they see it year one, and then how do you see it going forward, year two, year three, year four? And what is the vision of the government, sir? And what are the various plans that have been incorporated because of that vision?
Basically, I would like to make it clear that actually Khelo India is not a subset of Fit India. Khelo India is altogether a different scheme. A lot of difference between Khelo India and Fit India, because Khelo India is a government scheme for overall development of sports, and Fit India is a movement, it's not a scheme. The basic purpose of the Fit India is to create awareness among citizens of this country regarding the importance of physical fitness. It's a long-term goal, whereas Kelo India is having year-wise target that I think Minasuri would be able to make it clear much better because he is a director for senior director for Kelo India. Fit India is we can call it like a literacy program. It's like a Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and it's actually we are creating awareness among citizens the importance of fitness. So it's like a mission, it's like a movement, it's like a people movement, it's like a community driven program, and it's there is no year wise targets. It's a long way ahead. It's like if we can say if it is a literacy program, when we reach that 100% physical literacy target, then only we can stop this. So regarding the Kelo India scheme, Meena sir may be in a better position to say.
Meena sir, would you like to comment before we move on the Kelo India? Again, let's start with the what the vision is and how we are looking at year on year building on it.
Yes, जो खेलो इंडिया का विदुष्पत जो मेन है वो है ब्रॉड बेसिंग ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स कल्चर ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स इंडिया पूरे कंट्री में डेवलप करना और पाथवे ऑफ एक्सलेंस अचीव करना. तो इसमें जो हमारे टोटल 12 वर्टिकल्स हैं खेलो इंडिया स्कीम के जो टोटल 12 वर्टिकल्स हैं उसमें हम लोगों ने एवरी स्टेक होल्डर्स ग्रासरूट एथलीट कोचेज जो जो वेरियस स्टेक होल्डर्स हैं हमारे उन सबको कवर किया है. स्पोर्ट्स फॉर वुमेन है स्टेट जो मेन हमारा स्पोर्ट्स जो स्टेट का सब्जेक्ट है उसको किस तरह से तो जैसे मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूँ कि जो एनुअल स्पोर्ट्स कंपटीशन अगर हमारा जो वर्टिकल है उसके थ्रू हम गेम्स कराते हैं. गेम्स में जैसे अभी तक 4 गेम हो चुके हैं खेलो इंडिया यूथ गेम्स है जिसमें हम लोग अंडर 17 और अंडर 21 कवर करते हैं. खेलो इंडिया यूनिवर्सिटी में हम 25 कवर करते हैं. यूनिवर्सिटी जो पहली बार जैसा माननीय मंत्री साहब ने अभी बताया कि पहली बार यूनिवर्सिटी में और पहले ही इसमें मोर देन 3,500 एथलीट ने पार्टिसिपेट किया और 159 यूनिवर्सिटी ने पार्टिसिपेट किया. सो इसमें जो हम लोग जितना कंपटीशन वहां पे क्रिएट करते हैं उनको एक इंटरनेशनल कंडक्ट उनको वहां बच्चों को पूरा एक कंपटीशन का माहौल इंटरनेशनल कंडक्ट के थ्रू करते हैं सो दैट जब वो नेक्स्ट लेवल पे पहुंचे इंटरनेशनल और इंटरनेशनल पे जब खेलने जाते हैं तो उनको एक पूरा कॉन्फिडेंस रहता है एक प्लेटफॉर्म का उनको पूरा कंपटीशन का आइडिया रहता है सो दैट वो वहां पे भी उसी कॉन्फिडेंस के साथ इंटरनेशनली पार्टिसिपेट कर सकते हैं उस प्लेटफॉर्म के माध्यम से जो उनके पास. तो ये इस तरह से हम लोग मैक्सिमम पार्टिसिपेशन उन बच्चों के लिए इंश्योर कर रहे हैं. फिर जैसे स्टेट लेवल जो हमारी दूसरी स्कीम है स्टेट लेवल खेलो इंडिया सेंटर उसके थ्रू जो दो प्रोग्राम है वो है खेलो इंडिया सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस. खेलो इंडिया सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस के थ्रू हम एवरी स्टेट में जो उनका बेस्ट सेंटर है जो वहां पे बेस्ट स्पेशल सेंटर है उसको वायबिलिटी ये फंडिंग कर रहे हैं और उसके थ्रू हम जो स्पोर्ट्स साइंस है स्पोर्ट्स इक्विपमेंट है बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस के थ्रू वहां पे फंडिंग कर रहे हैं और उसको वर्ल्ड क्लास उस सेंटर को वर्ल्ड क्लास बनाने के लिए हम लोग उस स्टेट के साथ उसको पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं. देन हमारा खेलो इंडिया सेंटर जो नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम है उसमें नेक्स्ट 3 इयर्स में हम लोग 1000 खेलो इंडिया सेंटर्स एवरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ इंडिया उसमें एक या मैक्सिमम 2 सेंटर्स हम लोग खोलने का प्रोग्राम है और वहां पे इस स्पोर्ट्स इकोसिस्टम को जो हमारे देश का स्पोर्ट्स इकोसिस्टम है उसको और अच्छे से सुधार करने के लिए वहां पे जो चैंपियन एथलीट जो पास्ट चैंपियन एथलीट है जिन्होंने नेशनल लेवल पे एथलीट उन सबके साथ मिलके स्टेट के माध्यम से वहां पे पर ईयर एक स्पोर्ट्स के लिए 5 लाख रुपया वन टाइम एंड नेक्स्ट ईयर एवरी ईयर 5 लाख रुपया ये हम लोगों ने प्रोग्राम है और एक सेंटर में एक साथ 3 स्पोर्ट्स किए जा सकते हैं सो दैट एटलीस्ट 15 लाख रुपीज पर वन टाइम एंड एवरी ईयर 15 लाख विल स्पेंड एंड सपोर्ट टू दैट रेस्पेक्टिव स्टेट टू दैट डिस्ट्रिक्ट खेलो इंडिया सेंटर. एंड रिसेंटली अभी जैसे हम लोगों का खेल तभी बढ़ सकता है जब एवरी स्टेक होल्डर क्योंकि फाइनली जो मेडल है वो इंडिया के लिए आना है तो एवरी स्टेक होल्डर्स जो खेल पे प्रत्यक्ष और अप्रत्यक्ष इंक्लूडिंग प्राइवेट अकेडमीज अभी हमारे माननीय मंत्री साहब ने अनाउंस किया है कि 500 अकेडमीज प्राइवेट अकेडमीज उनको भी सपोर्ट किया जाएगा थ्रू with consultation with National Sports Federation. तो इस तरह से हम लोग every stakeholders के साथ मिलके इन government initiative के through grassroots athlete, community coaches और sports infrastructure को आगे बढ़ाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, so that हम लोग इस broad basing of sports को बढ़ा सकें.
Thank you sir. सर ओमकार सर अगर आप हैं सर तो इसी के मीना सर ने जो बोला कि ब्रॉड बेसिंग और स्पोर्ट्स एंड कोचिंग सेंटर्स बढ़ाने के लिए बात कर रहे हैं, खेलो इंडिया का इनिशिएटिव का वो एस्पेक्ट इज कि हाउ ग्रास रूट से टैलेंट उठाया जाए एंड हाउ एट द टॉप लेवल हम लोग वी विल बी एबल टू गिव देम द एक्सपोजर दैट दे कैन परफॉर्म एट द हाईएस्ट लेवल एंड दे डोंट गेट ओवरऑल्ड बाय दैट सर. सो सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट the Northeast and maybe we talk about Assam in particularly, so there are challenges pertaining to sports infrastructure, especially them having proximity to the athletes. So how do you think, sir, the Khelo India initiative and the Fit India initiatives can expand in Assam and the Northeastern states, and how what would you suggest are the measures to resolve and get it broad based in Assam and Northeast? Idea, sir. I think we might have lost Idea, sir, as well.
Okay, okay. Can you hear me now?
We can hear you now, sir.
Perfect. Okay, okay. So, thank you. Good evening to Honorable Minister and panelists. First of all, I would like to say that Khelo India scheme is different from all other schemes that we have heard about because it addresses the entire ecosystem. There have been schemes earlier which addressed infrastructure, some scheme addressed infrastructure, some scheme addressed coaching, some scheme addressed something else. But we cannot achieve excellence in sports unless we address the entire issues connected to the ecosystem. So this scheme, it addresses, like Mr. Mina said, there are so many verticals. And all these verticals, they try to address the ecosystem. And the beauty is that there is a lot of flexibility among these verticals. Funding in one area can be deployed for another vertical. And so this flexibility is going to be very helpful. And it also addresses both huge in sports, mass participation in sports, and excellence in sports. So that way, this is a very useful scheme. As far as Assam is concerned, Assam this year hosted the Khelo India Youth Games, in which around 8,000 participants were there. It was a very successful games, and it helped us upgrade the infrastructure that we already have in Guwahati. So the games themselves, the Khelo India Youth Games themselves, they lead to infrastructure upgradation. This is one part. And recently, we have got a center of excellence in Guwahati in Sarusajay, which is our biggest sports complex in Assam. So we will be able to utilize that expenditure, that infrastructure better, with the help of this assistance, which has been announced recently under Khelo India. We will get 3 crore rupees this year, and we will get 1.5 crore rupees from next year onwards. So this is also a very important part of Khelo India scheme, that it does not only emphasize the creation of infrastructure, it also emphasizes the utilization of infrastructure. And we will get a lot of district level centers also, about which Mr. Mina talked about. We are in the process of identifying the centers and completing the formalities. So if we get these centers at the district level, again, I think it will be a very good step towards creation of infrastructure and other sports facilities at the grassroots level.
So just as a follow-up question to what you just said, how many, since because of the Khelo India schemes, and I think Meena sir talked about that 500 private academies are going to be also incorporated within the Khelo India scheme. So, fact that we've seen in Assam, how many private academies have come to you and said, we want to enroll in Khelo India scheme? Have I asked you, okay, how can we enroll and what are the brief on this? And what is the kind of local level impact that you've seen, sir, in the state or in the region?
Private academies, you know that the government of Assam has been encouraging sports. Our chief minister, who was also the former sports minister at the center, he's holding the sports portfolio here, and he has been encouraging sports, including private academies. If you ask me about the impact, there was a lot of impact of Khelo India, which was held this year. And we got so many new young icons like Shivangi Sharma, who had a bag full of gold medals in swimming. We have Ankushita in boxing, and we had some icons even in gymnastics and other sports. So it has created a kind of an electrifying impact, not just in Guwahati where it was held, but in the entire state. And I think we just need to push the process and carry on with the momentum.
Thank you, sir. Vishnu sir, I'll get to you a very, very basic question that comes to my mind. So whenever we were in school and when we were studying, it was always padho, you know, study, that will only make you successful. No attention was paid to so much to sports or generally fitness on a larger end. I think there's an old muhavra that khiloge kudoge banoge nawab padhoge likhoge banoge nawab khiloge kudoge banoge kharab ro. And then how Fit India is looking at changing that whole basic thought that has been sometimes, as you say, inscribed in our brain. How is Fit India moving towards changing that thought process and, you know, making India a fit nation and getting people to understand the importance of fitness on a larger scale?
Yeah, the basic aim of the Fit India is to change that habit or inculcate the habit into the citizen of this country. As you rightly point out, actually, it's like we are creating awareness through various programs. Prior to COVID outbreak, so we tried to conduct a lot of events across the country like that. We conducted blog runs around 55,000 location, and a lot of people participated in like that. And we conducted school week across the school. And then COVID came, it became a huge challenge. Now it seems like an opportunity for us, because actually our awareness program, because people also slowly started changing into digital media. Also before, prior to COVID, our social media reach was very limited. Now if you see, our website is having a 3 crore visit. And most of our programs are being highly popular among children, and we are having almost 1.76 lakh schools on board. They regularly respond to our program. Right now also school week, now it's COVID, most of the schools are closed. Then also we have come up with the innovative idea of virtual school week. So people can actually participate, from students can participate from having some activities from home, and they can upload their video in social media platform. And these kind of things are becoming huge success also. People are actually started responding. It's like creating awareness through various events, creating awareness through media campaigns, and whatever may be the best possible. So basically, it's like a community-driven program. We cannot do it alone. So we are taking as many, even corporates and NGOs, different ministries, state governments, who are maybe available on board, we are taking all stakeholders together, and we are trying to slowly spread this message to grassroots, especially schools and village level, urban bodies. We are trying to, it's like an education program now, through physical events as well as digital media platforms, whatever may be the, even videos, and we are, celebrities are also on board with us. So our yoga program attended by celebrities recently. It's like we are finding fitness icons and trying to spread the message of fitness through all sort of things. Now we are going to launch one mobile app also. Age-appropriate fitness protocol has been already formulated and launched by Honorable PM. Now we will go with a simple, very simple mobile app, so that a citizen of the country can assess their own business, and they can. It's like a, it's a parameter there. Of course, there are a lot of mobile apps are there, or a lot of applications are there. But for government side, there is a standardized thing is going to each and every citizen of the country, but they are also having a stake to participate in our programs. They don't need to pay anything, and it's like an education program through whatever may be the medium possible.
So, taking from Q for you, Nilesh, as an education, you go to now, right? So, you know, education is, you know, how I would take it is, you know, initially when this program was supposed to be started, both Fit India and Khelo India, the whole discussions were that, you know, how will the students be able to commit so much to sports as well as to commit to education? How will they be able to balance it, you know? And eventually, because India is not a sporting nation, so therefore these programs will become redundant. You know, that is, I think, a larger discussion when this whole program started. I used to keep hearing people criticize it, you know? So one, what do you think is the impact and how you think is the future going forward since you've been associated with these programs? And the second question with this is, what are the essential learnings for the children in these programs, be it the Khelo India and be it the Fit India? What are the core learnings from this program?
Thank you, Virushpat. I think this is my batting order. So you talked about the opening bowling part. This is my batting order when I was playing cricket. So I'll take this as a honorable minister, distinguished panelists, and FICCI committee. First of all, compliments for putting up a wonderful panel and the entire turf event together. It's a wonderful event during the COVID-19. Coming to your questions, Vidushpal, I think I've heard all our panelists, and one of the key points which I personally feel I jot down something, for me from a takeaway perspectives and education standpoint, probably before Khelo India, India was always a sport-loving country. It was not sport-playing country. With the initiative of Khelo India and Fit India movements, it is slowly becoming a sport-playing country, which is an encouraging sight, because the more participation we see, the more engagement we see, it encourages youth to look at sport as a career option and not either or, which was the case when we started playing sport. So right now, the option, which the kind of numbers which we just heard, you know, Assam had more than 8,000 participants for a grassroots level. It encourages the broad base of participation of athletes picking up sport and then aspiring to play for Khelo India and then go on to play for the country. Honorable Minister just now mentioned about the way they conducted university games. See, in today's time, getting a competition, participating into competition to create a space for yourself and understanding where you stand itself is a huge motivational drive for a lot of youngsters. So for me, that's a fantastic encouragement. Compliments to Khelo India, DG sir, Honorable Minister, for encouraging these initiatives and establishing them as a concept. Because this allows not only the athletes to play, but mind you, coming from an education standpoint, there are more than 3,000 people to 5,000 people who work tirelessly to make this event a huge success, which itself is an opportunity for a lot of athletes who are associated with sport. If they can't make a career by playing sport, they can still think of making a career by getting themselves involved in sport, which for me is a very standout point, because it allows you to create a space and not think about a 9-to-5 job, but enjoy what you love most and still give it back to the sport. This has been a model globally, which is an established model, which I see as a positive outcome of these initiatives. And like Vishnuji mentioned, that, you know, Fit India is a movement. And for me to see those numbers, 1.6 lakh school participating, more than 3 crore footfall itself allows you, because, you know, globally, if you start looking at and comparing it, you get a student to participate minimum 2 to 3 sport. In India, we are a one person, one sport country, which is slowly changing. You're allowing a couple of more sports participation. So from that standpoint of time, I personally feel it's a huge shift. Coming back to your second thread of that point, I personally feel that the biggest area which we need to focus on is creating competitions. Like Omkarji mentioned, you know, having competition allows you to be more confident, allows you to be more competent, and then evolve. And with the initiatives of Khelo India, it allowed all the states to start creating more competitions. it allowed them to focus getting more funneled by having broad base of more participants and then selecting those to participate in Khelo India by becoming the number one state of medal winning, which is a very encouraging sight. And likewise, the university games also allowed students to continue playing sport, not leaving sport, because, you know, like I mentioned before, it was either sport or academics post your school days or post your 12th grade. So that now this allows you to pursue sport, make a career in sport, and make a career in academics as well. For me, this is the most encouraging and satisfying sight to see. And compliments to Mr. Behra ji and Omkar ji for becoming that torchbearers of developing states and setting up a different benchmark for other states to follow. Because that, for me, is a good setting up a benchmark for others to be that aspiring state to win medals and be that number one spot. Maharashtra has luckily has been in last 2 years have been number one, but other states are slowly closing in, which is an encouraging sign. And this is, first, in my opinion, will create more job opportunities, will create more opportunities for athletes to compete, and will give our Honorable Sports Minister and Honorable Prime Minister's vision a good wings of looking at 2028, where India, they aspire to make it into top 10 medal-winning tallies.
Thank you, Nirav. Let me ask you a bit tougher question, I think. you talked about aspiration of students, you talked about excellence. How do you see Khelo India moving from a mass movement to also producing elite athletes, one? And more importantly, when do you think we will have an Olympic medal from Khelo India athlete? Any guesses on that? Just asking a larger
question. Well, it's actually a tough question. But for me, I come from a cricketing background. The way cricket structure is established, when we had Sunil Gavaskar sir, then we had Sachin Tendulkar, then we had Virat Kohli, then we have the youngsters like Prithvi Shaw and Shubman Gill. Because of the process which is designed for talent to showcase, compete, and then come up and evolve as a talent. And with the initiatives of Khelo India, I see that as a fantastic hope of creating an opportunity for talent to showcase their talent, compete hard, and be more positive and confident to aspire to win medals for India. And to answer your question directly, by next Olympic, we should aspire to have a couple of athletes from Khelo India competing for India, aspiring to win medals for the country. But for 2028, which is the mission and the vision kept by our Honorable Sports Minister, we should aspire or hope to get more athletes competing for India and win medals at Los Angeles Olympics.
Meena sir, question aapke liye. Khelo India scheme mein aapka ek hai scholarship scheme also, jo aap log pan India you are implementing.
Yes.
I think largely that information I think is missing when Nilesh talked about students, he talked about academics, you know. Everybody, I think parents also look at it, how will we fund these schemes, how will our kid play for a long time, how will he be able to achieve excellence. And I think, can we talk about a bit more about this scheme, scholarship scheme that has been implemented by Khelo India, how it has been implemented and what is the impact it is having short term, especially during this COVID times and the long term?
तो जो जो जैसे मैंने आपको बोला था कि इकोसिस्टम के लिए जो हम लोगों के टोटल 12 वर्टिकल्स है, तो उसी में एक वर्टिकल से सपोर्ट टू नेशनल रीजनल स्पोर्ट्स अकेडमीज, तो इसी में जैसा जो हम लोगों ने बात किया अभी केडिया साहब ने भी बोला कि मास पार्टिसिपेशन जो हम लोग उसके लिए जो एक खेलो इंडिया स्कॉलरशिप जो स्कीम्स है इसमें हम लोग खेलो इंडिया एथलीट का जो आइडेंटिफिकेशन है वो हम लोग दो तरह से करते हैं. एक लोग एक एक है हमारा खेलो इंडिया गेम्स और दूसरा है नेशनल चैंपियनशिप जो वेरियस नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स फेडरेशन और SGFI के थ्रू से जो चैंपियनशिप हो रही है. इसमें हम लोग टू टीयर स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं इसमें हम लोगों का, वो है टैलेंट स्काउटिंग कमिटीज है एंड टैलेंट आइडेंटिफिकेशन कमिटीज है. इसमें ये लोग पूरा उसको टैलेंट को स्काउट करते हैं, उनकी परफॉर्मेंस देखते हैं, उनकी देखते हैं, देन उसको हम लोग वेरियस स्ट्रक्चर पे हम लोगों के हाई परफॉर्मेंस कमेटी है उनके थ्रू इनका सिलेक्शन होता है और वहाँ पे इनके एज वेरिफिकेशन होने के बाद एक एक खेलो इंडिया एथलीट का सिलेक्शन हम लोग हाई परफॉर्मेंस कमेटी के थ्रू होता है, तो उसमें हम लोगों का प्रोग्राम है 5 लाख रुपीज फॉर नेक्स्ट 8 ईयर्स के लिए, उसमें पूरा सपोर्टेड रहता है। तो एक बच्चे को जो खेलो इंडिया एथलीट जो चूज हुआ है उसको अगले 8 साल तक एवरी ईयर 5 लाख रुपीज पर एथलीट का उसको सपोर्ट मिलता है एंड 10,000 रुपीज आउट ऑफ पॉकेट अलाउंसेस, वो भी उसमें प्रोविजन है। तो इसमें उसके पास ऑप्शन होता है कि वो हमारा खेलो इंडिया अकेडमीज में एक्रेडिट अकेडमीज में वो पार्टिसिपेट कर सकता है या वो प्राइवेट अकेडमीज में पार्टिसिपेट कर सकता है और उसको इस तरह से सपोर्ट मिलता है। और ये जो और जो जैसा आपने हमको पूछा अभी कि किस तरह से जब COVID-19 सिचुएशन चल रही थी तो उस समय भी हम आउट ऑफ पॉकेट अलाउंस हमारे खिलाड़ियों को जो उस समय घर से रह के अपनी तैयारी कर रहे थे जो इस सिचुएशन के कारण अकेडमीज में या अपने प्रैक्टिस नहीं कर पा रहे थे तब भी उनको ये आउट ऑफ पॉकेट अलाउंस उनके घर पे हम लोग भेज देते थे। तो इन दिस वे दिस प्रोग्राम एंड दिस स्कीम इज सो इनबिल्ट कि उससे एवरी एथलीट जो खेल इंडिया स्कीम के थ्रू आ गया है जो जिसको स्कॉलरशिप मिल रही है उसको बेनिफिट हो रहा है।
थैंक यू सर। विष्णु सर आई विल कम टू यू बिफोर आई गो टू द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर। विष्णु जी यू नो सर वी टॉक्ड अबाउट आई थिंक नीलेश एंड सतीश मीना सर टॉक्ड अबाउट द फैक्ट ऑफ एक्सेलेंस एंड द खेलो इंडिया स्कीम एंड ऑल देयर इज अ स्ट्रक्चर्ड प्रोग्राम देयर। Now, Fit India is, as you sir, largely said, it's an awareness program. It is a larger program to get India fit and healthy. How would you rate the second edition of Fit India program? Was it a success or not? And especially, what is the next, the third edition of Fit India? How are we looking at doing and having activities around that in the sense that how do we make it a success post-pandemic, especially when health is taking such an important role in our thought process now?
Please give me 1 minute. Actually, I will make again. I need to make some clarification. There is nothing like a second edition of Fit India program, third edition. Let me. It might be perspective. The program started on 29th of August last year. This is the first, it's only close to first year, and it's like a continuous, it's like a movement. There is no special things. Every month we used to organize a lot of programs. Like that, we started the program on last year, then we got cyclothon, and then we got school events, then we had programs, then we are having during lockdown series, Fit India Indigenous Freedom series. Now also this month, this particular month, December, actually we are having cyclothon across the country. It may not have come to your knowledge or somebody means, but definitely a lot of programs are going on simultaneously. Now school week is being celebrated, cyclothon is being celebrated. In India's Prapath Fair is almost 13 lakh youth volunteers from NYGS participate in Prapath Fair. These volunteers actually going to villages and they spread the awareness of World Fit India. So these kind of activities simultaneously going on, and it's like a continuous program. There's a significant difference from Kelo India and Fit India. Kelo India is like a scheme with a definite budget allocation and with a definite period. Kelo India actually, it was initially, this revised Kelo India program was three years, and now it's extended for one more year. There may be a revision, it may continue for another, so that's all depends. But Fit India, there is no proper budget allocation also. There is like a movement, community driven. I am also stakeholder, you are also stakeholder, and we are also the volunteers. It is like it is a continuous day-to-day basis. It's going slowly. We are building. Within 1 year, actually, we could able to reach to villages, up to villages. So that itself is a big achievement. And so many people, at least 10-20% of the country is aware about Fit India. Itself is a big achievement. During the first year, so this is like a first year only. You can say instead of first edition, second edition. So second year, what you are going to do in second year or third year? Because a lot of activities simultaneously going on, digital world, physical activities, so many things, school level, and so many things simultaneously going on. There is no additions like that. It's a day-to-day basis continuous awareness program. It's going slowly. The second year we started. Next year, so we may have bigger achievements next year. That is what I want to clarify.
I know, sir, you've done India, blogging is there. I think the concept of blogging has been brought about. I think we heard about it distinctly, but now Fit India blogging and the Honorable Minister's involvement has brought it to the forefront. You know, even the run, Freedom Run, the cyclothon, as you sir rightly said, the Fit India Week. There's also a
school. And during lockdown, we had Fit India Active Day series. We had Fit India Dance Week. We have indigenous games through media. Media, indigenous, we promoted indigenous games. We promoted, we celebrated Yoga Day in a big manner. It got a 15 lakh viewership, 1.5 lakh viewership on our YouTube channel. And Fit India Talks, more than 3.5 lakh people again watched our program. And again, our Fit India Freedom Run. Social media actually had a reach of 36 crore, but not participation. But 6 crore people actually participated in Fit India Freedom Run movement. It was like a virtual run movement. Because this was like a just innovative idea. This kind of innovative, I like that. There is no need to go for a mass run, marathon. Anybody can run at their own choice. I can also have my own run, my own distance, my own convenient time. I can have a video and upload. Then I'm also part. So this kind of innovative ideas, and even now we started Fit India youth club certification. Already 28,000 youth clubs are on board within 2-3 weeks. So we are getting the youth club volunteers also for our this month campaign. And Fit India Dialogue, obviously our Prime Minister himself participated in, which Virat Kohli, Milind Soman, Devendra Jajari, and a lot of people. So this kind of, through this kind of programs, we are reaching out to people. We are trying to reach out to people on day-to-day basis.
Thank you. Honorable Minister Behra, sir, just I think the last question, because we're just running out of time, sir, so just maybe a last question, sir. With COVID, sir, participation has been affected, development of talent has been affected. So how is the Odisha government, and sir, as an initiative that you've taken to keep this continuous process of development, of keeping the youth engaged, to keep the participation at least in the youth level still there, and get this again, this whole program which has taken such an impetus in Feb, March, keep this going. So what are the various initiatives that the Honorable Government has taken?
First of all, I must thank Honorable Minister, Union Minister Sri Kiran Rijijuji. During the previous meeting with all the ministers from all the states and union territories at Delhi, Honorable Minister said, "Khelloge kudoge to bonoge lajabab." He has said it jokingly, but we must take it seriously. Nowadays, what is the biggest challenge before us is that if we are targeting for 2028 or 2032 Olympics, then we are trying to catch the kids at early age, let's say 10 to 12 age. That means in the schooling, in the school education system, the sports, commonly known as physical education class in Odisha, that should be mandatory. So there should be a change in policy in synergy with school and mass education department. We are moving ahead by arranging the meeting with school and mass education department as well as the higher education department, so that next year or next to next year, it will be mandatory and some portion of marks will be attributed in 10th class. In the school curriculum, the physical education class is already there, but it is not mandatory in 10th class. So that's why students are not serious about the subject. So in this pandemic situation, we are not emphasizing on making it mandatory from coming 2021, but surely we'll do that in 2022, or maybe before that we'll put that policy change. And apart from that thing, we are conducting training of PETs who are working in school in virtual medium, and also we are conducting some of the quizzes and other things to create interest among the school kids. But the important thing, I must say, the change in policy in school education system should be in such a way that all the states, I mean, this is my humble suggestion for all the state, so that the people who are interested in sports from 6 to 7 class, I mean, at the age of 10 to 12, they must be aware of all the things which are happening at the state level, at national level and international level, and so that the interest will keep in mind. That is the main thing.
Thank you, sir. So I'll just wrap up with maybe my last thought process before I can thank the panelists. So I think from what I can hear from our discussion is, one, Odisha has been leading this university game. The kind of impact and the kind of numbers that we've seen are astronomical, and we hope that, you know, that kind of impact continues at the Khelo India Games and generally for the sports movement across the country. As Vishnu sir said, that, you know, initially Fit India Movement started and it's an awareness program, and the reach has reached the grassroots level to the rural level, and people are now already aware of Fit India and the Honorable Minister's words. So we are actually reaching the absolute grassroots bottom village level. So that is the success of the Fit India Movement. That is the impact of the Fit India Movement. Meena sir talked about also, and Omkar Kedia sir also talked about the fact that Khelo India Games has also managed to get more and more academies together. It has managed to get a fund students even in these times of pandemic, where they are getting the regular funds so that they are not impacted and their training and their livelihood is not impacted because of this. And, you know, they're continuously still motivated enough to participate. And we are looking forward to the next edition of the Khelo India game. So with this, I would thank all the panelists and Honorable Minister sir for participating today in our discussion. Thank you so much for making time this evening.